Hi everybody, I'm Jamie and it's great to have you here. Windows 11 is packed full of AI-powered features, and today I want to show you five of these tools to help elevate your Windows experience. So the first tool on Windows 11 that I want to go to is going to be Copilot, if you haven't tried it yet. Now I have Copilot right here, so I'm just going to click on it on the taskbar. If you haven't turned it on, check to see if you just right-click on the taskbar and go to taskbar settings. Take a look if you have it on or off here, and let me know down below in the comments if it isn't showing up at all, because I actually had to go through another step to install it, and let me know about that. So with Copilot, if you haven't tried it on Windows 11, you can still give it a try online. So if I open up Microsoft Edge right now, you can see up in the top right-hand corner, I can also get to Copilot this way right here, and you can compare the two side by side. They're going to do many of the same things for you. I'm going to be showing you on the Windows 11, and it has a few extra things that I can do to control my computer. I do want to point out, if you just go to bing.com and go to chat up here, you can also get to these same features, or many of the same features, so even if you're on a different browser. But let's just stick to this one right here on our Windows 11. Now, of course, it can write for you just like ChatGPT and other tools are creating content. We can use it to do that. So I can look in different ways. It's going to categorize them. Do we want to be more creative, more balanced, or more precise? And each time I click one of these, it's going to give me that option. Now, I don't want to spend the time in writing, but really quickly, I could click on a suggestion that it has, and I can go through and have that conversation as the content gets created for me. So you can see it actually went through, searched online, gave me a list, even put some suggestions for shopping on it. Now I can also go back and clear everything up top and ask it a different question, like drawing a picture. So let's say draw a cat surfing, and it will go through and actually create this image for me. So you can see it created these different options where I can click on them and get to the one I like and download it from there. Now, what I want to really show you is how you can control your computer using Copilot, because a lot of people don't realize that with the Windows 11 one, you have certain features. So here's an example. If I go down and start typing start focus session, just like this, and I'm going to hit tab and hit enter. So what this will do for me right now, it's going to let me say how long I want a focus session for. And when it goes through this, it will make sure that I don't get any distractions from other things. So it's going to take Windows 11's notifications and stop them. You can learn more about all the different things you can do with this, but I can tell how long I'd want to set the timer. Now, I just want to show you a couple of other things that you can quickly do would be things like opening an app. So if I just say type in open Word and hit enter, it would know to open Microsoft Word. It will ask if I want to confirm it, but then if I hit yes, it will go and control that and can see Word opening up like this. Now, some other features that I can do with this, and I'll put the list here so you can try, you can enable Do Not Disturb, turn on Bluetooth, enable dark mode, set volume level, mute volume, change wallpaper, snap windows, manage devices, and take a screenshot. Also, what I want to point out is you don't have to be typing this all the time. Take advantage of using the microphone. So if I go ahead and click this, and let's say I tell them to change the wallpaper. Notice I have the personalization, the background. This is where I can make the change right there. So take advantage also of the voice typing inside this. When was the last time you opened up Microsoft Paint? If you haven't looked at it in a while, it has some new AI features embedded into it. So let's go ahead down below. I'm just going to open this up. It's in my recents. You can do a search for it. It's just Paint. And when it opens up, If you haven't used this before, what you can do is some basic drawing and photo editing in here, but that's really not what I want to focus on. It's just a few of the AI things that they've added into it. So I'm going to add a picture really quickly from this folder. I'm going to add this picture just by dragging it across, and I'm going to zoom out a bit so you can see the picture. Now, it has a quick way to remove the backgrounds now just by clicking a button. So if I go up to here and remove background, it's going to just take a few seconds, and you'll see it does a pretty good job at removing the background. So that's the first feature that I want to show you that's built into Microsoft Paint. The other thing I want to show you, and I'm just going to go new document here or new canvas. I'm not going to save this. I want to show you the co-creator, because this option is just like in Copilot, how it drew the picture for me of the cat that I had before surfing. If I go up top, I have co-creator right here. So this is built into Microsoft Paint, and I can go ahead and type what I want. So if I say pig riding a dragon, like so, I can pick the style that I want. So I could go, you can see the different ones from charcoal to watercolor. I'm gonna go and say watercolor, and I'm gonna hit create. Notice that I have so many different tokens that I can use when I'm doing this. It goes ahead and gives me some options here. Notice I get a few other options. If I click up on these ellipses, I have save image or give feedback. But if I like one of these, I can just click on it and it adds it to my canvas. And I could do some other tools to this. If I wanted to crop it, I could save it, change the color of the background and different things like that. So just some overlooked things that people don't realize that Microsoft Paint has in it now. We're going to stay with photos, and I'm going to open up the photo app to show you the AI that's embedded in that one. So down below in the search, this is the one I'm opening up, is photos. I'm going to open this up, and I'm going to select a photo to show you how I can use AI to make some edits. So I'll choose this one right here and right click, or you could go up to hit the edit up here, but I'm just going to hit edit, and it's going to open up in this view here. And the AI, and I'm just going to stretch this out here, and I hit okay on this. The AI that I want to show you is within this. So this is remove the background, kind of similar to what happened in Paint, but I can actually blur the background here too. So if I go ahead and select this, right away it's going to find kind of the images that stand out in this photo. And they picked the kids here, and notice that I'm in this one and the dog, and it's going to be blurred. But if I want to make sure that I'm in it or the dog, I could turn on the brush and subtract from here. I could increase the brush size if I want, but I can go through and select an area that I wanted to make sure that wasn't being blurred. So I go through, do this, and this might not be that perfect, but just to show you how this works. And I can make those adjustments on it, and I'll go ahead and hit blur and increase the intensity. You can see the dog's clear, I'm blurry, the kids are there. I can also remove the background, and I can replace the background. So if I wanted it to have a color in the background, I can go through and do that, and just by a few clicks make those adjustments. Then I can either reset or apply and then save this. Did you know in the snipping tool, you could extract text from an image using AI? So I'm going to go ahead and opening up the snipping tool this time. And when we do this, we just go ahead like normal. We can pick our screenshot that we want. And let's say I go take this image right here. That's off of Google Chrome. I'm just going to pop back open up. And now if you take a look at this option right here, so text action. So if I click on this, it will go through, recognize the text in the image, and I can go copy all text. To show you that it works, if I just go over to Microsoft Word to a blank document, I'm going to go Control V and then just paste this in. So if you want to take text from an image, try the snipping tool with the AI embedded in it. The last tool that I want to show you today is Microsoft ClipChamp. So this is a video editor on your Windows computer. I'm going to go down below to the search. Here it is right here. If you don't have it on your computer, you can go to the Windows Store and download it, install it. I'm just using the free one on my computer that I'm showing you here today. So when this opens up, you'll see right away that you can go ahead and create a video with AI. If you want to learn how to create a video kind of from scratch, I have a tutorial on that that I'll put up above in the card. But I'm going to go and click this right here, and I'm going to start with giving it a title. So this is just going to be called dog stuff, just like that. And media, actually I'm going to cancel out of not clicking in there, but I have a folder right here. So this folder I have, and I can drag things over. So I could drag multiple. So here's some images and videos here. So I could grab multiple, and this is even audio. I could drag it over just like that. So I could take, if I don't want them all in, that's fine. You drag what you want over. But just as this demo, I'm going to go ahead and click get started now. When it goes to the next scene here, I can go and choose what type of style that I want. So if I hit thumbs down, you can see how it goes to the next one. You can keep going through. When you like what you want, we can just go ahead and hit next. What do you want? Do you want this in portrait? So maybe you're uploading it to YouTube Shorts or TikTok. What's the length? I'm going to keep this shorter here, and I'm going to go next. I can do a little preview down here. Just like this, as you can see. And you get the idea of the time on it and everything as it goes through, and it shows how the different videos that are in it and the effects, the music, it's all being done by AI putting it together. So I can hit export at this point, and it's gonna go and put a finished video that I could download, that it is gonna be downloaded on my computer, and then I could upload it to where I want. Another AI feature in ClipChamp that I want to show you is how easy it is to add captions to your videos. So I just went ahead and put this video in ClipChamp, and I just had to turn captions on. So the captions, if you notice, if I hit play, as the captions go through, up in the top right-hand corner, captions were turned on. I can go ahead and turn them off, and it created everything that I can download in this transcript right here. So you can see you have the options to download them. I can hide the captions on the video if I'd like as well. So it's a great way to make your videos more accessible for everybody. I also go over more editing, as I said, in that tutorial about ClipChamp that's connected up in the card. So I hope you liked this walkthrough of these different AI tools and features on your Windows. Let me know if you're using any other ones that are already on your Windows machine, or are you using Copilot? What are you using it for? Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.